Torsten. Thank you very much for taking the time to do this discussion with me. I'm really happy to bring this to the Enlit platform, sharing knowledge from the experts. My name is Florence. I am a content director for Enlit Europe. This discussion will be about sector integration, all in the context of the energy transition, of course. Torsten, you are head of European regulation at the energy company Innogy. You are actually an economist by formation, and you actually spent your whole career in the utility industry, something like 22 years. You must really like the sector. Torsten, how are you doing?
Fine, thanks, Florence, and thanks for having me here and for giving me the opportunity to share some thoughts. Indeed, I'm working for Innogy. Innogy is part of E.ON Group since last September, and E.ON Group is also about customer solutions. That's the supply side, but we, of course, mostly have distribution grids for electricity and gas in 8 different member states of the European Union, plus Turkey, connecting some 35 to 36 million customers. And I think we are one of the, not only one of the largest DSO groups in Europe, but also one of the most diverse, because we have DSOs of all different sizes in different countries.
So Torsten, sector integration is no news to you. And this is what we're going to talk about today. And I'll just jump right in with some questions. Sector integration is proven an essential element of the transition in an effort to decarbonize, because its aim is essentially about optimizing the systems. So what's your point of view on the status in Europe today around sector integration?
I think we are at an extremely interesting moment and an extremely interesting junction for sector integration, or as the Commission now prefers to call it, energy system integration. We came from sector coupling to sector integration, and now it's energy system integration. And I think that really makes the point more clear. We will have communication from the Commission on smart sector integration or smart energy system integration on the 24th of June, which will set out main lines on how we will go forward. And then we'll try and see what framework we'll have on a European level and how we can implement that. I think it's essential that we keep in mind that energy system integration is not only about how much gas are we going to have, how much are we going to electrify, what's the role of hydrogen, how can heat come to the to the mix, but it is essentially also about the level of integration and where it's happening. And it's not only happening at the system level, it will also happen at the local and regional level. So we will have local and regional optimized energy systems, maybe even some very small ones, starting with a single prosumer, then going on to energy communities, to small communities wherever it makes sense, to small distribution grids, to larger ones, and of course also to the system. And we should definitely not forget about this aspect of energy system integration, that it really means we are not only integrating whole systems, but we are integrating units at the local and regional level, and thus also enable the actors to handle the complexity associated with it.
Mm. And about defining roles, actually, prosumers, small communities, commercial operators, DSOs, this is actually the start. Then finding agreements about interfaces, conditions of cooperation between the different actors is then the next challenge. But is that the biggest challenge according to you, or if not, what is?
Well, at the moment, it definitely is the next challenge. I think last year, everybody woke up to the necessity to define cooperation between and interfaces between at least electricity and gas DSOs, where they're both active, and also incorporating heat, maybe incorporating mobility concepts. We've devoted a lot of time in the years before to discussing and devising cooperation between TSOs and DSOs, and maybe about DSOs and DSOs of a level below, but we weren't going cross-sector. And I think last year we really came to the necessity to discuss that, but we didn't really make so many progress. So I think this is now the real challenge, is how to get the actors together. And getting the actors together is, of course, is the regulated entities, the grid operators, but it's also all the others. It's all the competitive actors, and most of all, of course, flexibility service providers, because you link systems, to use the old term, you couple systems, couple sectors by using flexibility in one sector or the other, and the flexibility service providers play a crucial role there. But then there is another point. I think that this complexity can be organized to a certain extent on a market-based, in a market-based approach, because you have the FSPs, you have the suppliers, you have their interface, you have the distribution system operators that works to a certain extent. But once you get into more complex systems, I think the decision on how these systems should be integrated, to which degree and exactly where the geographical scope, what could be taken in and how, where is it optimal to leave it out and to integrate it maybe on a larger scale, that will be extremely difficult to organize that through a purely market-based approach. We need the market-based approach for efficiency, but we also need organization. And I'm convinced that regulated entities, that is mostly in that case, of course, the DSOs, should have a crucial role wherever it's appropriate in organizing these optimized, integrated, cross-sector energy systems.
Very nice. And so is it, am I right to say that perhaps in the end, it's a question of mindset also? Is that what is the bottleneck here? And because we talk about converging, is this perhaps because sometimes one is shortchanged? Could that be part of the problem here?
That's a very nice question. I still remember the, and you will also remember, you don't have to go back that far, the days at least three years ago, when at least the electricity side said, where energy transition means full electrification and we don't need any hydrocarbons anywhere at all anymore. I think everybody is beyond that now. And we recognize that different purposes need different, of course, always clean solutions. So that's why we also have a significant role of hydrogen. And that of course, is a good example for mindset that has changed. It's not just electricity all the time, it's us together. However, integrating these energy systems is not just a matter of defining interfaces and having formulas and saying who can do what, but also it's also a matter of working together with each other. And especially where you have multiple DSOs and don't combine electricity and gas, for example, in one. And yes, we still have to go some way there in order to put that into reality. But once we start demonstrating what the benefits can be, to the system, to the system operators, but also to customers connected, and how we not only make systems manageable, but also enable active participation, resulting in better acceptance from grid users, I think that will then change the mindset. So I wouldn't say mindset first and then let's do things, but we really have to start doing things and that will automatically change the mindset.
Fair enough. We need to start to encourage the rest, I guess, or show best practice and good examples. Torsten, thank you very much for your time. I hope we can have a coffee.
My pleasure again.
I hope we can have a coffee somewhere soon. I don't know how soon, but we will at some point. And anyway, we'll keep on discussing and take this very interesting topic forward. I wish you a great day and please stay safe.
Thanks a lot, Florence.